Hello viewers, welcome back to UN College Digital Classes, and we are discussing a very important paper, that is Financial Market and Instruments. And in the Financial Market and Instrument, we are discussed many things. Today we are going to discuss a very interesting topic of which you all are aware and you must be using or participating in that, and that is none other than banks. So banks are the financial institutions, those are of high use, or we can say that the banks are the one, those are the major contributor of the financial system. So today we will have a look and discuss in detail about the Bank of India, or we can say the Commercial Bank of India. So we will be discussing the commercial banks. And first, let's start with what these commercial banks mean. So the commercial bank is a type of financial intermediary, and it is a financial intermediary because it intermediates between the savers and borrowers. And it does so by accepting deposits from the public and lending money to businesses and consumers. Its primary liability are deposits, and the primary assets are loans and bonds. So commercial banks make money by providing and earning interest from loans such as mortgage, auto loans, business loans and personal loans. And the customer deposits provide banks with the capital to make these loans. So this is what a commercial bank is. So what a commercial bank, by commercial bank what we mean, that it is a financial intermediary. When we have started the paper financial system and financial market we are discussing, so in the financial system we have various constituents, and of that the financial intermediaries are the major ones, or they are the important constituent of the financial system. And of these financial intermediaries, the banking are the major intermediaries between the savers and the borrowers. So who are the savers and who are the borrowers? We will have a quick quick look on that. The savers are the one who have the excess money or idle money, or the money that are not in use. And the borrowers are the one, those who are having some innovative ideas, those who have some investment ideas, and they need money. They have the need of money. So they go to these intermediaries and they borrow money from that. So the savers will provide money to the banks or these financial institutions, and the borrowers will take money from them. So these banks or the commercial bank is a financial intermediary between the savers and the borrowers. And how this financial intermediary, or specifically if we'll talk of the commercial bank, are operating or generating their money? They are generating their money or capital by accepting the deposits from the public or the one who have excess money or those who are the savers. And how they are making money? They are making money by lending or by giving the money to the one, those who are of need of those money. So this is how the commercial bank is operating, or we can say that this is what a commercial bank is. So now this financial intermediaries that we are talking of, the commercial banks, they are, how they are been classified, we will look into that. So this commercial bank is been classified into two categories, that are the scheduled commercial banks and the non-scheduled commercial bank. So what this scheduled commercial bank and non-scheduled commercial bank is, that we have gone through and we have very vividly discussed the Reserve Bank of India and the various aspects of Reserve Bank of India, and we have a wide knowledge on the Reserve Bank of India in our previous classes. So and we know that the Reserve Bank of India is the apex body, and it is the one who is going to regulate the entire financial system. And we know that every financial institution is under the Reserve Bank of India. So when we are talking of commercial banks, they are also under the guideline of Reserve Bank of India. Those commercial banks, those who are under the second schedule of the Reserve Bank of India, they are known as the scheduled banks, or they are listed as the scheduled commercial banks. And there are other commercial banks also, those who are not included in the second schedule of the Reserve Bank of India, and they are under the category of non-scheduled commercial bank. Again, this scheduled commercial bank is being classified into four categories, that are public sector banks, private banks, foreign banks, and regional rural banks. So these are the four categories, those are under the scheduled commercial banks. And in the public sector, again, we are classifying that into SBI and associates, nationalized banks, and other public sector banks. So this is how the commercial bank has been classified. Now we will look in detail that what these scheduled banks are. So scheduled banks are those banks which are included in second schedule of Reserve Bank of India. As we have said that according to the Reserve Bank of India Act 1934, under the second schedule, so there are certain financial institutions that are the scheduled banks. And a scheduled bank must have a paid up capital and reserves of at least rupees 5 lakhs. So 5 lakh rupees must be the paid up capital of the scheduled commercial banks, and RBI provides special facilities including credits to scheduled banks. So RBI is also providing various facilities to these scheduled banks, those who are under the scheduled bank list. And apart from that also, what the RBI is providing credit facility to these scheduled banks. And scheduled commercial banks can be further divided into four groups, as we have said. Those are the public sector banks, and in public sector we include the SBI and its associates, nationalized banks, and other public sector banks. We have private banks, foreign banks, and regional rural banks. So this is what a scheduled commercial bank is. So in scheduled commercial bank, as we have said, according to the RBI Act 1934, the banks, those who are there according to section 49, those who are there under the second schedule of RBI, they are the scheduled commercial banks, and they must have a paid up capital of more than rupees 5 lakh or at least rupees 5 lakhs, and they are getting various facilities by the Reserve Bank of India, including the credit facility. That is why these scheduled banks are supposed to be more, more secure, or we can say that they are more being adored by the Reserve Bank of India and by the financial system also. And these scheduled commercial bank has been categorized, as we have said, in different categories. Now we will go in detail and look into that how this classification of scheduled bank are done. So first we will go in detail with the public sector banks. So at present there are 27 public sector banks in India, including SBI and its associates, and 19 nationalized banks. And recently in 2019, actually, these nationalized, there are reforms in these nationalized banks. It was previously 19 nationalized banks. We will go in detail and look into the reforms of 2019. And further, there are two banks which have been categorized by RBI as other public sector banks, and these two banks are IDBI and Bharatiya Mahila Bank. So this is how the public sector banks are categorized. Now we will see that what are SBI and SBI associates. So SBI stands for State Bank of India, with its around 17,000 branches and around 200 foreign offices, and is India's largest banking and financial service company by assets. So you must be aware, or you must be hearing the name State Bank of India. It is a very widely known name in the banking sector, and that is the one which is the largest banking and financial services in the country, and it has having thousands of branches present in every nook and corner of the country. This bank got birth in the British era. So it is the oldest bank which took its birth in British era, and its first parents were three presidency banks, that are Bank of Calcutta, which is later known as the Bank of Bengal, then Bank of Bombay, and the Bank of Madras. So these three parent or presidency banks are the first parents of the State Bank of India. And in 1921, these three presidency banks were merged in one entity that is called Empirical Bank of India. So in 1921, so these are three presidency banks. So the three presidency banks that are there at the British era, that are the Bank of Calcutta, Bank of Bombay and the Bank of Madras. So these presidency banks merged together in 1921 to the Empirical Bank. The Empirical Bank of India was nationalized in 1955 and was renamed as State Bank of India. So these, the merged presidency bank in 1921, that is the Empirical Bank, was nationalized in 1955, and that Empirical Bank of India was renamed as State Bank of India. So this is what the history of the State Bank of India is. Thus, the State Bank of India is the oldest bank of India. And in 1959, there were 8 associates of State Bank of India, and the current 5 associates of State Bank of India are the State Bank of Bikaner and Jaipur, State Bank of Hyderabad, State Bank of Mysore, State Bank of Patiala, State Bank of Travancore. So apart from the above, the State Bank of India also have 7 non-banking subsidiaries, that are the SBI Capital Market Limited, SBI Funds Management Private Limited, SBI Factors and Commercial Services Private Limited, SBI Cards and Payment Services Private Limited, then SBI DFHI Limited, SBI Life Insurance Company Limited and SBI General Insurance. So apart from the banking sector, there are other financial services or other financial areas that also the State Bank of India is covering. It is the oldest bank of India and it is having the other associates also, which is which we have discussed. So this is what the State Bank of India is, which is the major public sector bank of the scheduled commercial banks. Next is the nationalized bank, and there are 19 nationalized bank in India, and that are Allahabad Bank, Andhra Bank, Bank of Baroda, Bank of India, Bank of Maharashtra, Canara Bank, Central Bank of India, Corporation Bank, Dena Bank, Indian Bank, Indian Overseas Bank, Oriental Bank of Commerce, Punjab and Sindh Bank, Punjab National Bank, Syndicate Bank, UCO Bank, Union Bank of India, United Bank of India and Vijaya Bank. So these are the 19 nationalized bank. So recently in the year 2019, there is a reform in the banks, and the 10 major banks are been merged into four banks, and we will go in detail and read about that. But previously and a few years back, this is the structure of the nationalized banks, and there are 19 nationalized banks as we have discussed. So what is this bank nationalization? So in 1969 and again in 1980, government nationalized private commercial banking units. And nationalization is done for channelizing banking capital into rural sectors, checking misuse of banking capital for speculative purposes, to shift from class banking to mass banking, that is social banking, and to make banking into an integral part of the planning process of socio-economic development in the country. So nationalization is been done in two stages, we can say once it is done in 1969 and again in 1980, and by this nationalization, what government is trying to do or what government is trying to bring in is to strengthen the economy by giving the banking facility to every sector and every area, and to make it reachable to the rural sectors also. And the nationalization is done to strengthen the banking form and indirectly the economy of the country. So this is what the bank nationalization is. Then another category is the other public sector banks. And further, there are two scheduled commercial banks in India which have been classified as other public sector banks, and these two are the IDBI and the Bharatiya Mahila Bank. So the IDBI, that is Industrial Development Bank of India, and the Bharatiya Mahila Bank are the two specific banks that are under the scheduled commercial banks, and they have specifically done to emphasize the specific sector of the economy. Like we can say that IDBI is specifically designed to promote or to boost or to look after the industrial sector of the country and to bring development in the industrial sector of the country. So apart from the public sector banks, we have private banks. So what are these private banks? So in private sector banks, most of the capital is in private hands. And there are two types of private sector banks in India, that are old private sector banks and new private sector banks. So private sector banks means what? As the name suggests, that most of the capital or the ownership or the share or the holding of the bank is with the private people. That is why it is the private sector banks. As in the public sector banks, most of the holding or the share is with the government. That is why that is the public sector banks. In private sector banks, again, we are categorizing them into two categories, that are old private sector banks and new private sector banks. In old private banks, there are 13 old private sector banks, that are Catholic Syrian Bank, City Union Bank, Dhanlakshmi Bank, Federal Bank, ING Vaishya Bank, Jammu and Kashmir Bank, Karnataka Bank, Karur Vaishya Bank, Lakshmi Vilas Bank, Nainital Bank, Ratnakar Bank, and South Indian Bank. So these are the 13 old private sector banks. Also, it has Tamil Nadu Mercantile Bank. And in the new private sector banks, the new private sector banks are incorporated as per the revised guidelines issued by the Reserve Bank of India regarding the entry of private sector banks in 1993. So at present, there are 7 new private sector banks. So in 1993, Reserve Bank of India revised the guidelines and it included 7 new banks into the private sector folders. So these 7 private banks that are in the new guidelines, or which we are saying as the new private sector banks, are the Axis Bank, Development Credit Bank, HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank, IndusInd Bank, Kotak Mahindra Bank, Yes Bank. These are the 7 banks, and apart from the above, there are 2 banks which are yet to be commence operation, and these have opened in principal license from RBI, and they are the IDFC and the Bandhan Bank of Bandhan Financial Services. So apart from these 7, there are other 2 which are to be obtained the in principle license. They are the IDFC and Bandhan Bank. So this is what, or this is how the private banks has been defined and classified under the commercial bank. So out of those banks, the Nainital Bank is a subsidiary of the Bank of Baroda, which is 98.57% stake in it. And some other old generation private sector banks in India have merged with other banks. And for example, we can say Lord Krishna Bank merged with Centurion Bank of Punjab in 2007. Sangli Bank merged with ICICI Bank in 2006. Centurion Bank of Punjab merged with HDFC in 2008. So this is how the private sector, or we can say that the private banks, have been operating. And this is how the private sector commercial banks are operating in India. So in our further class, we will be discussing further the classification of the commercial banks. So keep watching. Thank you.